This is Andy Porowal for Boxing Social in association with Betfred. As everybody can see, I'm joined by a very happy and a dancing Eddie Hearn.
Yeah, Eddie, I don't know what I was doing there. It's dead dancing, Andy. When you get to 42, you've got to understand, when you dance, however good you think it looks, it don't. I'm not sure you're much of a dancer either.
I can actually dance it.
Stop, thank you.
You ain't seen me yet, so that'll be a story for another.
I love the way you went, well, actually, I can actually dance.
I said it with confidence, Ed, so that's how you know. I've also just seen you selecting a variety of food, I believe.
I'm trying to be really good at the moment, and I just walked over to Nanny Bill's, is it? And they were ordering some chicken and burgers, and I was like, and then no, but I've seen Clean Kitchen over there, I don't know what that is, maybe I'll get something here.
I mean, if you're trying to eat clean, it sounds like that's the place to go. But obviously, we're here. It's the weigh-in. Eddie, we're only one day away. We haven't seen a pair of them on the scales, but from what you know, how are both of them looking? How are both of them feeling?
Tremendous. I mean, John Ryder, you know, great work with Dan Lawrence and Tony Sims. He's really, really in great physical condition. Super strong. He hasn't really been out of the gym. It's been a quiet year for him with just a couple of eight-rounders. But he's in brilliant physical condition. And Danny Jacobs as well, unfortunately for John Ryder, is also in great condition. He's got a strength and conditioning guru called Scooter. Both got great strength and conditioning members of the team. And Danny Jacobs, the difference of him up at super middleweight is he's walking around at 172, 173, 171 during camp. Whereas when he was at middleweight, it was such a huge struggle to make weight. So both are going to be in brilliant physical condition.
Whoever wins tomorrow night, does he have to be a career best performance?
For John, it does. I mean, I see Danny Jacobs as the favourite this fight. I guess the questions are, I know Danny's got the desire still, but, he is towards the back end of his career. Can John Ryder put in the kind of performance, put him under pressure enough to break him down? If John decides to try and box him, which we said, it's going to be a tough night's work because he's really good. And Danny seems in a really good place, really confident. But John seems really excited as well. It's a massive opportunity for him. It's a couple of miles from where he lives. He's fighting an American great in Daniel Jacobs. So he's really up for it.
Kash Madiev seems to be a bit of a sleeper fight, obviously. Those in boxing know about it, but Madiev's been very confident throughout this weekend.
Well, it's a bit worrying when Madiev said he's going to school Felix Kash every round. Felix Kash is really good. Really good. I think he's the best middleweight in Britain. But we'll find out on Saturday night because it's a really good fight. And I love these kind of fights because fair play to Tony and Felix. Madiev, it wouldn't matter to the general viewer if it was Madiev or some guy that was half as good as Madiev. You wouldn't know the difference. We know it's a proper fight. And that's what we want. We want a proper fight.
Scott Niguanini again. Ellie Scott is stepping up quickly.
Yeah, good fight. I mean, look, Ellie's. It's difficult with Ellie because I feel like she should be fighting for world titles now, but she's only had three fights. So it's just the case of giving her the experience, giving her the rounds. I feel this is a perfect opponent. She's a former world champion. She's very tough. She's here to win. But I think Ellie's a special talent, and I think she'll win this fight, and I'd like to see her fight for the world title next.
Hope he is back out here, back out in Leeds. What is the plan for him this year, provided both shows go to plan?
I want to move him quickly. I really feel like Hopi is a fantastic talent. It's just his age. That's the reason you wouldn't move him as quick as you would someone, maybe with a few more years on the clock. But he'll have a good fight on Saturday night, get the rounds in, and then get out. I want him in a big fight in Leeds. I want him in a championship fight, and I really feel like he can clean up domestically this year.
Ammo Williams, now it might not be the opponent you wanted, obviously Jess Smith was spoken about, but for Ammo now moving forward, he said last year he wanted an Andrade or somebody like that this year. Is that a feasible route?
I mean, Jess Smith unfortunately pulled out. Maciel's tough, very durable. I don't think he ever gets stopped. I expect Ammo to maybe stop him actually, but I think, again, going back to Hopi Price, it's just about rounds. It's just about experience. Like, Ammo wants to fight Chris Ousley, which is a really good fight. He wants to fight Anthony Fowler, which is a really good fight. You've got Felix Kash even on the card. That's a big fight. Ammo's a star. He just needs a few more outings and a bit more experience. But he will be thrown in the deep end in the fight after this. So I'll let him enjoy maybe a little bit of an easier one on Saturday before he starts moving into 50-50 territory.
You mentioned Anthony Fowler. They've had a rivalry which has grown for some time. Do you anticipate that could be one this year?
I love the fight. I mean, look, Fowler's a step ahead of Ammo in terms of where he's at in his career of championship fights. Ability-wise, we'll see. But if the fight's big enough, right now Fowler might be looking at Ammo going, what's he got for me? But maybe in a few fights, what he might have is a big fight, a big night, a big paycheck. And Fowler's always up for fighting, big fights and taking on big challenges.
back from his car, just a few topics to quickly whiz through. Eddie, Dalton Smith, Sam Maxwell, yeah, officially ordered.
Fantastic. We pushed for that fight. I want that fight so bad. It's a great fight. Dalton Smith's a great talent, supposed to be out in Leeds. I believe Dalton Smith's going to go through everybody domestically, and I think he's going to be a world champion as well.
Purse bid's the most likely scenario in that case?
Yeah, I don't know, Sam Maxwell, if he's with Pro Bellum or MTK or Frank, well, I don't know, but you know, we'd be willing to put that fight on, of course. I'm sure someone else would as well, but if not, we go to purse bids and may the best man win.
Just want to go back to something that we spoke about yesterday. You said that if Usyk AJ 2 does happen, as we expect, most likely outcome would be on DAZN pay-per-view. Does that mean, you said it would be likely that he would end up on DAZN pay-per-view. That's if he did go to DAZN, yeah, I mean, that's what I mean. Like,
yeah.
So that's what I want you to pick up on. Yeah. Has he made his decision on the network yet?
Oh, no. But, you know, at the moment, he's got several offers, obviously not just from Sky and DAZN, but other offers as well, fielding. So, you know, look, he's got a great relationship with Sky, and it's a great platform for pay-per-view. So, you know, I think maybe they're front runners to get that extension. We're reviewing all the offers with Freddie Cunningham and 258, and ultimately AJ will make a decision when the time is right. And obviously, that will be in conjunction with Alexander Usyk as well, because he's part of that first fight and the show. So, I don't think anything's imminent in that, but obviously it will need to be decided before or when the show is announced.
What does he actually want? Does he want a long-term network deal or more of a fight-by-fight basis?
Depends on the deal. You know, I like... You've seen the benefits of a fight-by-fight deal with Canelo Alvarez. Now, this is something that only a couple of people can do in the world. AJ is one of them. But if there's a long-term deal with great security and it's the right move for AJ, he'll look at that. You know, it's one for him, again, 258, Freddie, myself, just to look at and all give our opinion on what is the best opportunity for AJ. And then he's the boss, he'll make the decision. So they'll all be reviewed. And like I said, you know, there'll be a plethora of opportunities and deals and structures. And we'll see which one works out best.
What is the relationship still like between yourself and Sky, Eddie?
In what respect?
Just in general, obviously, having left them to join up with DAZN, are things still amicable or have things become strained?
You know, we have a long-term deal with them on the darts and other sports as well. I mean, you've just seen the darts event at Alexandra Palace break all records, the viewing figures through the roof. So, yeah, I don't think that, you know, I'd like to think that we left on good terms for boxing, but our business is a lot bigger than just boxing, and we have a long-term deal with them. As I said, on the darts, it's hugely successful. Great people, a lot of friends there as well. It's just friendly competitive, which is, I think, good for boxing.
Apart from that, Eddie, you said yesterday that there was nothing official or nothing close to being announced for Canelo Alvarez. Eddie Reynoso backed that up last night. So when do you expect to hear something or be able to let us know?
I don't know. I think that, you know, that sort of story that broke from Mike Coppinger, you know, kind of put the cat amongst the pigeons a little bit, because it's kind of like, where's, you know, and a lot of Mike's stuff, you wonder where Mike gets the info from. And most of it, he's right. And you know, I know that he said a deal hasn't been reached yet, which it hasn't. And that's really where we are. Eddie Reynoso, what he said in his statement was 100% true. He's got offers, he's reviewing them, and when he decides what they're going to do, he'll let everyone know. So, as I said yesterday, hope that's us. We feel like we've presented him with a great opportunity, but Sal and Eddie will do what they feel is best for his career.
Seen some quotes about David Benavidez. I said he expects to see Plant and Charlo next now. With that in mind, you'd be open to facing Demetrius Andrade. Is that a fight which you think could happen next?
Love Benavidez against Andre. We'll do that now. You know, we have this plan, this route with the WBO and WBC that they've put together, but happy to go straight into a Benavidez fight. No problem at all. And you know, Benavidez is right. He needs, kind of like Benavidez needs, I rate Benavidez, but he needs a big fight. He needs a statement. And so does Demetrius. So maybe they can get it on together.
Where did things currently stand with Zach Parker fight?
There's negotiations ongoing with Queensbury to do that fight. If we don't reach an agreement, it'll go to purse bids, but we're talking to them. I think Frank's got a meeting with them next week to try and see where that fight could take place.
Final topic, Eddie, the lightweights. Giorgio Camboso has been very vocal over social media, saying that DAZN and yourself just aren't backing him to try and make the Devin Haney fight. Your thoughts on his recent comments?
I don't know where Giorgio Camboso gets his info from. It's a bit worrying, to be honest with you. DAZN want to make the Devin Haney Camboso fight. They'd also want to make the Ryan Garcia Camboso fight. And You know, I keep seeing stuff about, oh, Devin Haney's backtracking. Devin Haney's ready to get on a plane and go and fight George Kambos in Australia. No problem at all. You know, he won't outprice himself, he won't try and be smart, but it's like someone's telling someone that Devin's not interested and DAZN aren't interested. Of course DAZN are interested, and of course Devin's interested. So we've been speaking to DAZN to try and move that forward, and if George Kambosos is watching this, we're ready. We're ready. If you've got money in Australia, like you say you have, if you've got all these 80,000 fans, if you've got this, you know, we're ready. And DAZN and us will work on the rest, and we can get it done real smooth.
He said he's had no offer yet from you guys.
We've made an offer to Luda. It's not the whole thing about, you know, this is a guy who has won all the belts nearly, is going to be, wants to promote a major event in Australia, right? Yet we have to make an offer. I don't really understand. But we have put forward to Luda Bella how this fight can work and how Devin Haney's purse can get covered without affecting George Kambos' money. So again, we've done our bit in writing. We've never received an offer for Devin Haney in writing. I had a conversation with Luda Bella, no official offer for Devin Haney. We are ready to move forward and make that fight. It can happen like that, that quick. So hopefully people can actually start moving productively in the right direction.
Final one, he said DAZN prefer to make the Garcia fight because he pushes more subs or he's got a big, better following. Just your thoughts on that?
Ryan Garcia is a big name, big draw. I think they'd be happy with either. Ryan Garcia is a big fight, but would you, you know, Ryan Garcia is supposed to be fighting in April. He ain't going to be ready to fight again till the end of the summer. And would you back that when you've got a chance to make an undisputed fight right now? We can lock that fight in for end of April, May, and it can be done. And the winner can fight Ryan Garcia. But someone's saying something for a reason, and we'll get to the bottom of it.
We will do, Eddie, and we'll leave that there now. Thank you.
Cheers, mate. Thanks.